possible for...
Then, too, don't forget that although the agent must know the life insurance business from A to Z, he does more than just look after the insurance needs of policyholders. He also puts the company's many services to work where they're needed and available. Take our nursing service, for instance.
I'll never forget that nursing service Tommy received.
When Tommy came down with pneumonia, the doctor said the Metropolitan nurse helped him save Tommy's life. She recognized the danger and reported every detail right away.
Yes, and remember the way she taught me to take care of Tommy between her visits.
Yes, that's the story we get from lots of policyholders all over the United States and Canada. Why, you'll find Metropolitan nurses in over 7,700 cities and towns.
Who gets that service? Everybody?
No, it's chiefly for those who carry Metropolitan's industrial or group insurance. Nurses visit them when they're sick at home under a doctor's care. And you know, those nurses make nearly 2 million visits a year.
It's a wonderful service, all right. And those health booklets you've been leaving with us ever since we took out our first policy, they're a gold mine of information. Those booklets on the heart and on overweight, they're really excellent.
Oh, yes, I remember now. You got those when you were a little worried about George here. Regarding those booklets...
The Health and Welfare Division, with its staff of health and safety specialists, is constantly at work preparing authoritative and up-to-date health information for policyholders. For a third of a century now, the company has been distributing health and safety booklets at the rate of one every second. That's more than 30 million a year. The company also publishes similar information through magazine advertisements, which have a total circulation of about 375 million copies per year. The policyholders benefit by such efforts to prevent disease and extend length of life. For the decrease in mortality affects the cost of insurance. Premium and dividend rates on life insurance policies both reflect death rates. The story of how premiums are determined goes to the very heart of the life insurance business. Premium calculations are made by actuaries, men skilled in the science of life insurance mathematics. These engineers of the insurance business figure out what the policyholders must pay to cover the cost of the benefits provided in their policies. With the help of records kept over many years, they can tell you very closely not who will die this year, but how many. The premium a policyholder pays is based primarily on the normal death rates for the insured group to which he belongs. For example... suppose we start with 1,000 youngsters at the age of 10 and follow them down the years. Life may begin at 40 for some of them, but it will have ended for 91. At the age of 60, 303 will be missing. So over the years, while fewer and fewer premiums come in, more and more money must be paid out. If premiums for each year were based solely on the death rate in that year, they would grow larger and larger as the policyholder grows older. Then who could afford these large premiums in the later years? The way to protect you against that heavy load during the later years is to even out the premiums. In this way, during the early years, they amount to more than is necessary to meet death claims. And in later years, when the death rate is high, less than is necessary. Because only a portion of the early premiums is needed for death claims, it is possible to build up a fund to take care of the deficiency of premiums in later years. This fund is invested throughout the country to earn interest. In fact, for each dollar the company receives from policyholders in premiums, the company's investments bring in about 22 cents. You can see how this interest on the company's investments reduces the premiums of policyholders right across the years. Now we have seen two of the things actuaries have to think about in estimating the cost of life insurance. The first is the death rate,